Hello, I'm Chad Grusin.
And I'm Josh Bernstein.
And this is SiAtCenter.
Let's go!
Welcome.
This term was an unbelievable season for the Simon Atlas AZAA football program.
It sure was, Josh. The Tasmanian Devils went 2 wins, 1 tie out of 4.5 games. This season sure had some unforgettable moments.
This year's team was run by the coach, Olive Gary Asher. He did an amazing job and was actually able to get some wins for the Simon Atlas football program this year, weren't they, Chad?
Yeah, you know, the wins aren't everything, and it definitely isn't necessarily the coach's fault if they don't win. Okay, moving on. Some of the other things that may have affected this was, like, injury that happened throughout the season, like right. Adam Vinner and his surgery.
But there were some really good upsides to this. Don't forget about our defensive efforts. We had an amazing defense this year. We had some great guys come out and play their best. Alex Paul, Jared Shapiro. I mean, they had an amazing season. Two young stars. You can just see their potential.
Yeah, and let's not overlook what like is always overlooked: the offensive and defensive lines. You know, Adam Main, right. Zach Silver, Ben Harris. They all just played amazing. And yeah, you know, there was that quarterback Ben Schick. Yeah, he had some really nice touchdowns, but. You know, let's not forget that he had numerous interceptions and 2 safeties, because some people forget about those things.
And don't forget about that amazing special teams. I mean, who would expect it? They did not let up a single touchdown
on special teams. Not one.
Well, actually, Jacob Stillman came up after me and did say that he did not touch the guy on Osei, but... Technically.
You know what? The refs were very nice that game. Right. Max Alpert, Victor, and of course Stillman,
amazing,
as you said.
Amazing.
The punter, however, was terrible. Like, I would not give him credit with that.
Right.
Anyways, let's look at a clip to see one of the amazing plays this season.
Cut.
Go.
Cut in.
Oh, come
yeah,
on.
go! No, don't go backwards.
Now, Josh, Sia was notorious for getting extremely pumped for these games.
They sure were, Chad. I mean, I gotta tell you, those fans, they were crazy out there. They brought it definitely on the field. Why don't we take a look at another play from the team?
First series?
Chad.
Defense, first series. We're gonna keep it real standard, see what they're gonna run. Here we go. No trick.
As the season went on, Coach Gary Asher went through a lot of adversity and had a lot of trouble finding a good punter. Gary started searching.
He really did, Chad. I mean, I really thought that Coach Asher really took the initiative in coaching this team. I mean, but let's not take it from us. We sat down with Gary himself, so here it is.
Hi, guys. Welcome to our press conference. I'm going to be answering a couple questions here.
Why was it so difficult to find a punter when you had a team with so many soccer players?
Well, I think there are two primary reasons why we couldn't use the soccer players. The first one, they seem to have a hard time kicking a ball that's not perfectly round. I don't understand it, but you know, it's a little bit upsetting. I mean, I tried them out, it didn't always work out. And the second reason was because soccer players, they don't like to use their hands. It's something called a handball. But in football, you have to hold the ball with your hands before you punch it. They just couldn't get that to their heads. They were trying to just drop kick the ball. It just didn't work out. Second question.
Who were the best options you had at punter, and could you reveal who you thought performed the best?
Well, I think we had a lot of options at punter. Harris Block obviously was one of them. Max Alpert tried out. Sam Lawrence. I think even Brandon Shapiro tried out once. But I think the best was probably Eric Asher. I mean, he had a lot of willpower. He really wanted to do it. But he had a little bit of trouble because he was holding his computer the entire time trying to kick.
Who are your top 3 athletes from the team as a whole?
I think the first one would be Adam Maines. I mean, he was kind of a beast. You were scared if he was stepped in front of you. He'd run at you. You don't even know if he was trying to hug you or beat you up. It doesn't matter. You just went out of his way. The second one was probably Ben Harris. There's a good combination of size, strength, speed, and all that stuff that makes a really good football player. My last one was Brett Wagelstein. I mean, he's so fast and so elusive. He just knows what he's doing. He comes in, he might come out a little bit early, a little bit tired, but it's fine. He does well when he plays.
Do you think you should be considered an elite coach? Why not?
Why, yes, I do. We won our first game in 2 years. I think that's pretty impressive. But the reason why I really think I should be is I really took on the head coach status. The head coach of the game doesn't really actually coach the team. He's more of a figurehead. And I did the same thing. Elliot, and his friend in the playoffs, they wanted to be coach. I'm like, okay, you know what? You'll be offensive coordinator. You'll be defensive coordinator. I'll be head coach. And that's how it worked out. And that's what a good head coach should be.
How do you think Ben Schick did at quarterback this season compared to the previous ones?
Next question. I'm just kidding. I'll answer that. He was... Next question.
Is there a fine line between playing time and winning, and where is that line in your mind?
I like to go about halfway, you know. It's important that everybody gets to play, but at the same time, if we can win while we play, it really just makes it all better.
How do you prefer your sandwiches, crust on or crust off?
Crust, but I like both. I like half crust on one half and crust off the other half. Yeah, I like to have a good combination, good for both. Next question.
In what ways did it help having Elliot there to cheer the team on?
It didn't.
Walk us through that play where you were picked off by Ed Pohl and Azier in the last play of the game and let up a touchdown in their only points but kept the victory.
Well, I had a strategy for that. See, those kids at Ed Pohl, they weren't very good. They didn't have a good team. They were very dispirited. They even couldn't get enough kids till like halfway. We only got to play half a game, basically. But, you know, the reason why I did it, I did it on purpose. I was running. I did an easy touchdown throw to Brian Shore, but there was the eight polling guy there. He looked depressed. He looked upset. He looked like he'd never come again if they didn't score. So I'm like, you know what? I'll give him that, because I'm that good of a coach. So I threw the ball to him. I didn't even run after him. I just let him go all the way. Our team still won, but at least they got their spirit up for next year. Thank you very much.
Wow. That was a riveting interview. Coach Gary can be quite inspirational.
Yeah, and he shed his inspiration on his players. This year, Gary did an especially good job of playing all Olives, no matter what grade. I'll tell you, those freshmen, they are special. That is a special class, and they made a huge impact in this football team this year.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about, Josh. Two really big standout rookies were safety Jared Shapiro and wide receiver Brian Jordan. Yes, I recruited him. We're having both of them here to answer our questions today.
Chad, I've just been informed that Brian will not be here to join us today.
Oh, really? That's such a shame. I guess we'll have to settle for Outback Steakhouse. Punter Hair Salon.
Chad, I think you mean Outhouse Steakback.
No, who would ever want that on their jersey? Outback Steakhouse is so much cooler. Anyways, here he is.
Welcome, Jared and Brian. I mean Harris.
First off, Jared, you had a great year at AZAA football. Harris, you did okay. Were either of you surprised at all with the amount of playing time you received on offense, defense, and special teams? Jared, you first.
Yes.
Actually, it was a very good season for me, and I was really surprised how much playing time I got.
I got a decent amount of playing time, you could say.
Do either of you feel there are any other ninth graders of your caliber?
Sam Lawrence. Definitely have to say Sam Lawrence.
I think you got the wrong kind of football there. Harris, what were the challenges of being punter other than the kicking the ball? What were the mental impacts this position had on you?
What do I do with my hands?
Now, Jared, what was it like to have to fill in for Adam Binner as running back in the beginning of the season?
It was actually kind of hard because I was playing safety and running back, so it really took a lot. I got more playing time, but it was really tough and it really tested my endurance. I mean, Harris wouldn't know how that feels, but it was tough.
Harris, punters aren't usually the ones who tackle the returner. Were you ever able to accomplish that? And if so, did you have a technique?
Yeah, you gotta go for their leg. I mean, it's really all you can do.
What are you two looking forward to most about AZAA football next year?
Playing offense and defense, and punter.
No, that's all I have. Don't take it away from me.
No, I used to be goalie. Be a piece of cake.
Shut up.
You shut up.
And...
Whoa there! Let's not get it out of hand. Thank you, guys. We'll be back after a word from our sponsors. When we get back, we'll be talking about playoffs and how it all went down.
Playoffs? You been talking about playoffs? We'll be right back.
Va a pegarle Ronaldinho Gaucho. Ya lo hace. Pierna de Diego al arco. Golazo! 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 Golazo!
Golazo! Oh, snap! Comes up.
So, as Josh said, we had playoffs.
Sadly, the bracket seeds were not completely accurate, thanks to DC Council Mosqueer Eric Fleischman.
Coming in 4 seed, Vegas predicted SiAt to win it all.
But our first challenge, the Mighty Beavers of Osei Shalom.
Yeah, it turns out they were the only team we played, but it was fine. We had a good run.
It was a well-fought match, and SiAt even scored first, but unfortunately, Ben Schick, he threw a few interceptions, a lot of interceptions, actually. There was a safety, and Elliot and his friend just weren't that good coaches, and I mean, Osei had a lot of ringers, so what can you say? We played well, but it just wasn't enough.
Yeah,
a little bit short.
Yeah, I see what you're saying, Josh. You know, it was a pretty good season for SiAt.
Right.
We had a win, our first win in 2 years, which I completely blame Robbie Adler for.
I blame you, Chad.
Well, I blame Robbie, and I don't like you. So, and we showed the council that we should be feared in the upcoming AZAA basketball season.
Right, yeah, we got that AZAA basketball season coming up, and I'll tell you, those freshmen, we got a good team coming up. But now, before we leave, we have Jared A. Smith in the studio to give us his scoop on the season.
Thank you very much, Chad. Thank you very much, Chad. I would like to welcome my friend, Mr. Skip Bayless.
Thank you for having me on the show, Mr. Stevens.
No, thank you, Mr. Skip.
I would like to propose a question to you. Who do you think should have taken the reins of this football team in the past term?
Now,
Mr. Elliott? Mr. Gary?
Yes, 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 I completely understand you, Skip. Now, Skip, Elliot Golden is a brother to me. He's a brother to me. He's a Jew of good moral character. But in the fourth quarter of the Simon Atlas AZAA playoff games, the only one who should be coaching the football game is Gary Asher.
Why?
He is Gary Asher!
Okay. Well, I disagree. I think it should be Elliot coaching the team. He left 2 wins out of 4.5 games.
I respectfully deny that decision, Skip.
Why?
It's Gary Asher! He's a Jew of good moral character!
What about Elliot's friends? He was there for very big emotional support against that playoff game versus Osei. What do you have to say about that?
Skip, Elliot's friend? He's a friend of a brother to me. He's a friend of a brother who is a Jew of good moral character. But in the fourth quarter of the Simon Atlas AZAA football game, the only one who should go to the football game is Gary Asher.
Well, since I can't get a clear explanation now, Mr. Stephen A., thank you for joining
us. You want clear? Chad is clear! Let's go back to Chad!
Thank you for joining us. Let's go back to Chad and Steve.
No, thank you, Mr. Skip.
To finish the show off today, we have a top 10 and a not top 10 from this season.
Throughout this year, our media specialists, Jake Derby and Brendan Shapiro, have caught some amazing footage from the plays that can be described as amazing, incredible, and sometimes just downright dreadful.
Dreadful.
Here they are right now.
Jared, hop on this side.
Jared, get it!
Jared!
Yeah.
Okay, don't let him catch it. Victor, get out!
At number 8.
Oh, watch the short pass! Holy BK, go up on them! Someone please get that!
Ryan!
Zach, you got this?
When do you leave it?
Yes!
There's a minute left, buddy. If you want to get in, you gotta get in now.
Gary, Tom, come here.
Hey.
Hello?
15 seconds.
Okay, yeah, there's a minute left.
10 seconds.
All right, bye.
I tackled you, and I was going to pass. I feel like you ripped my jersey. I'm going to rip.
All right, Tigger, you want to play the
He's like a really good team.
Hey!
Tell.
Okay, do your best.
I think people might be blocking it, but.
Hey, Poland was an art chapter, that's right.
Same play.
Chat.
Yes.
No.
No.
Go. Cut in.
Oh,
yeah, go! Don't go backwards.
Well, we spent the entire week celebrating great things.
Don't ignore me, Gary.
Shouldn't Gary be coaching that play?
What?
Spray bottle.
I'm pretty sure Chad turned interception in the first game.
At number 8.
Guys, that's...
Oh my goodness. It's 3-on-1.
Offside. Offside.
Thank you, Gary!
Oh my
god.
Yeah, I'm just gonna stop.
Wow, those are some pretty sweet plays right there. Thank you for tuning in. From Gaithersburg, Maryland, I'm Josh Bernstein.
And I'm Chad Grusin. We'll see you next time on SiAtCenter.
Da-da-da! Da-da-da!